everyone, and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered that what are JavaScript-driven web pages. In our today's session, we are going to talk about Selenium. So guys, what is Selenium? We will be understanding that. What all things Selenium can do, we will be understanding that as well. And how we will be installing Selenium, we will be seeing that in this video. So let's get started, guys. First of all, we'll talk about what is Selenium. Selenium, guys, is a very powerful tool which can automate any web browser. So if you have a web browser, if you want to make any automation over there, for example, you have seen many such codes, like in many movies, they show these things where they just run a code and automatically gets login and the password is there. And then it goes to some website and some page and, you know, all the things happen. So all these things that happens on the browser. So these things, these automations happen because of the Selenium. We will be learning that Selenium in this video. If I talk about Selenium, Selenium is an open source library. It supports cross-browsing. Now, what is cross-browsing over here? That means you can work on Chrome, you can work on Mozilla Firefox, you can work on Edge. Okay. And it is used to automate web applications. So any web application is there, you can easily automate it using Selenium. Selenium, if I talk about the compatibility of Selenium, Selenium is compatible with many languages like Java, C#, PHP, Ruby, Perl, Python, JavaScript, Objective-C, Haskell, and R. And it is compatible with different platforms as well. For example, Windows, Linux, Mac, Android, iOS, and different browsers as we have talked about it earlier. So this is how much compatible Selenium is and how much powerful and strong it is. If I talk about advantages of Selenium, Selenium has many advantages. It is best for testing. So if you have heard about that, you know, these coders or programmers, they do the testing of the website. So that can be possible with the help of Selenium. It has easy installation. It is an open source library. It is very easy to learn. And when we combine it with Python, it becomes much, much more easier to understand, much, much more easier to learn. Selenium can easily send standard commands of Python to various browsers irrespective of all variations in the design of the browser. So with the Python, we can easily send the codes and we can easily automate any browser. We will be working with the Chrome browser over here. For that, we will be downloading the Chrome driver as well. Also, why one should choose Selenium is it's an open source and portable. It is easier to understand and implement. It's less burden and stress for testers. So it's very easy for the testers. The automation process is very easy for the testers. So I hope, guys, that here it is clear to you that what Selenium is. And in this whole module, we will be learning about Selenium. Like in the upcoming all sessions, we'll be talking about Selenium, where we will be learning, we will be creating some amazing projects. We'll be creating a project on Twitter as well, that how we can automate the process of logging in and sending the password. And then we will be also learning to scrap the tweets from Twitter. Also, we will be combining beautiful soup with the Selenium to extract these tweets. And we will be doing the same thing for the other websites as well. So I hope, guys, that as of now, Selenium is clear to you. Before we end this session, we need to install Selenium as well. So for the installation of Selenium, we will be opening our command prompt. On command prompt, we will be typing pip install Selenium. And for Selenium, I'll tell you the version, the exact version which we are going to work on. So it has many versions, and the latest version sometimes have bugs. So I'm telling you which version we are going to use. So here we will be writing Selenium double equals 4.0.0.b4. And as soon as I'll press enter, for me, it says the requirement is already satisfied. In your case, it will get downloaded. Once we are done with this, we have installed the package of Selenium in Python. In our next session, we are going to talk about how we can install driver for Chrome. So stay connected, guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.